check this out.
Two.
Hey, it's a bad chat.
Yeah. Y'all didn't see this coming. Yeah. Here we go. Come on.
It's like to own 100,000 trees.
It's the hottest show in town. It's the baddest show all around. It's the hottest show in town. It's the baddest show all around. It's the hottest show in town. It's the baddest show all around. It's the hottest show in town.
Welcome, this is the Bruce Brooks Radio Show, Baltimore's number one station. Log on right now to magic957fm.com. That's magic957fm.com. Today is Thursday, April the 11th, okay? This is the Bruce Brooks Radio Show. As always, the hottest shows with the hottest topics. Tonight we're going to be talking about creating your goals. Creating your goals, learn how to reach your potential and setting goals in your life, okay? Give it your all, man, and be very, very detailed and very clear about what you want in life. We're going to talk about it right here on the Bruce Brooks Radio Show. I'm your boy, DJ Biz. You know how we do it. Let's get this party started. Here's Alicia Keys featuring Maxwell. Fire We Make, right here on the Bruce Brooks Radio Show.
How you doing?
'Cause we're gon' survive. We
Welcome back to the Bruce Brooks Radio Show. Log on right now to Magic957FM.com, Baltimore's number one station. We're talking about creating your goals. You know, a lot of people have dreams, goals, aspirations of doing something, you know, positive with their life. And, you know, they don't know where to start. You know, they don't know what to do with what they have. So hopefully today, by the end of the show, I'll be able to help someone to find, you know, what it is that you enjoy doing. Okay, and turning it to a profit or just doing it for a hobby, it's up to you. Okay, because you may have a job that you like. You know, some people like that. They like the 9-to-5 job. That's cool, I understand. But if you're trying to find a way to make money for yourself, then you need to stay right where you are. Grab a pen and paper right now because you're ready to get down with the get down. We're going to be talking about creating your goals. As containing to life, your business, your job, your family, your finances. That's a big one, okay? Your career, relationships, even on a spiritual level, okay? Now, plan goals that are controlled by you, okay? When you plan a goal, the first thing you want to do is find out what it is that you're good at. What it is that you like doing. And turn that into a profit. I don't care if it's from playing a piano, you know, to building a website. Whatever it is that you enjoy, or doing something with your hands. You know, a lot of people like to work with their hands as a hobby. Okay? You can turn that into a gold mine, okay? Where you can make money for yourself, where you don't have to work for someone else. Okay? But write it down. Once you find out what it is, you have to write it down, okay? Plan goals that are controlled by you. Now, these goals are only attainable by you. Why? Why? Because they come from you. You wrote them down. You saying that this is something that you want to do. This is a goal that you want to reach, okay? And you have to take these itty-bitty steps to reach that goal. As an old saying, how do you eat an elephant? Bite by bite. So, when you write down these goals, you have to, you know, kind of like take it bite by bite. In other words, step by step. Step by step. Because if you don't do anything, then of course you're not going to get any results. So the goals that you write down are only controlled by you. Controlled by you. Not your friend. Not your husband or your wife. Not your parents. They're controlled by you. Like I just said, write them down. Create time to yourself. Sacrifice. A lot of people have goals and things that they want to do, but they don't have the time to do it. In other words, they have time. We all know there's only 24 hours in a day. They have time. So what you have to do, you're going to have to cut something out. Whether it's hanging with your friends, whether it's playing games, whether it's watching TV, whether it's on the phone 2-3 hours, okay? Whatever it is, you're going to have to cut something out because you have to create time for this task, for the goals that you wrote down on your paper. It's going to take sacrifice. There's going to be days when you're not going to have to go or want to go anywhere to hang out with your friends. Or go down to the club, you know, or just chill with the family. There's got to be a time, there's got to be sacrifices made if you want to have a business. Even if you don't want to have a business, there's got to be sacrifices made because sometimes you just need time to yourself. Sometimes you just need to get away, man, and just concentrate on you. With all that's going on in the world, all the craziness, sometimes you just need to get away and concentrate on you. So sacrifice whatever it is. Make time, make time, make time. If you don't make time, nothing is going to happen. The Bible itself says it. Faith without work is what? It's dead. So if you don't take action towards something, if you don't do something, if you don't say to yourself, I'm not doing this tonight because I have something that's more and more important to do. You have to take the initiative to to create your own financial, okay? Your own financial. It's going to take time and money. If you're trying to build a career out of this, out of your goals that you wrote down, it's going to take time, like I just said. And a lot of the cases, it takes money, man. So if you have a 9-to-5 job that you're doing, cool. Put some money aside to save towards your goal or your career. You want to go back to school? Fine. You want to start a business? Fine. You want to help someone out? Fine. Whatever it is, you're going to have to put some time aside, and you're going to have to be focused. You're going to have to be dedicated, man, and you're going to have the mindset, the right mind frame. See, everything starts in the mind. It starts in the mind. So once you get in the mind, once you visualize what it is that you want to do, and you meditate on it. Meditate. And then when it comes down to the real deal, the final results, you can see how much progress you made. But you got to do something. It's more than just say, I want to do this, I want to do that, I want to be this, I want to be that. What are you doing? Are you taking itty bitty steps? See, take some kind of steps, because if you don't take any steps at all, then you're not going to go anywhere. Not for your scratch it off list, okay? Not for your scratch it off list. Now, everything is not for everybody. So if you have something down on your list that you just feel, or maybe you had a second thought about it, say, well, you know, maybe this is not for me. Maybe I don't want to be an artist, okay? Maybe I want to be, you know, something else, whatever the case may be. That's cool. That's fine, because everything is not for everybody. That's why you have to search within yourself. You have to search within yourself and find out what it is that you enjoy doing, man. I believe everybody has a talent, man, a gift, or something that they can do, or something that they can use to help them or to help someone else. You just have to find that niche. You have to find out what it is. It took me a while to find out what it is. About 5 years ago, you know. I mean, I didn't know that I had this in me, but, you know, a friend of mine, I tell this story all the time, a business partner of mine who I met online, a lady who by name was Dorothy, she lived in Florida at the time, inspired me to get in radio because she said I had very, very good marketing skills, you know, internet techniques, and we talked a couple times over the phone, you know, about business and stuff like that, and she heard my voice. So she said, you should get in the radio, you know, and use it as a marketing tool. So at first, I didn't think anything about it. So 2 weeks later, I did research. She gave me information. She told me what to do. I went to his website. I signed up. And I did it, man. I did it. So October 7th, this year, it'll be 5 years of doing this radio broadcast. And I thank God for it, man, because, you know, without her, I probably would still be, you know, doing what I was doing at the time. And this here is so much better. Why is it better? Because I enjoy doing it, man. When you enjoy doing something, you do it every day, man. You can't wait to do it. You sleep about it. You dream about it, you know. Because it's something that you like to do. It's your passion. Health. Lose weight. Get in shape. Okay? It may be something involving your health. You may want to lose weight, or you may just want to, you know, get in shape. Whatever it is, man, creating your goals. Write down how many pounds you want to lose in so many months, weeks. You want to lose 5 pounds? Cool. You want to lose 20 pounds? You want to lose 30 pounds? You want to lose 100 pounds? Guess what? You can do it. Eat right. Exercise. Daily. Write it down. If you don't write it down, nothing will happen. If you don't take action, nothing will happen. I want to share with you real quick before we end, man, something I heard. I seen a video on Tony Roberts. Okay? If you know Tony Roberts, he's a motivational speaker. Man, he shared with me, man, some information that was awesome. He wrote down four blocks. If you can, just write down. Just do a square, four blocks. Okay? Four squares. In the square to your left, write the word potential. Potential. In the square to your right, write the word action. Okay? Action. Now, on the third square, on the bottom, under potential, write the word beliefs. Okay? Beliefs. And the last square, write the word results. Okay? Results. As I was saying earlier, man, we all have something in us. We just have to tap into it and find out what that talent is, that skill is. Okay? Potential. We have potential. We know we got it. We know what it is. Now we have to find out what we're going to do with it. Action. This is where you have to do something now, see. If you want to get someone involved in your company, if you want to motivate someone, then you're going to have to take action. You're going to have to take what it is inside of you and make that work. Even if you got to do research about it. Even if you got to ask someone, you know, about it. But you're going to have to take some kind of action to move forth. Okay? After action, then what? You get results. You get results because you have done something. You have potential. You acted upon it. You did something with that potential that you have. And now you have results. So you believe at this point in time that you can do it. You've seen it. You've done it. Okay? You know you can do it. So after the result comes beliefs. Now you believe you can do it. See? Potential, action, results, beliefs. Those four words is a part of our lives. We just have to find out, like I said earlier, what it is that we enjoy doing or that we want to do. If this applies to you, you need to write this down. Potential, action, beliefs, and results, man. Okay? Progress makes people excited. Progress. When you show people what you have done, when you show them the results of, you know, what happened to you, that makes them happy. And when that makes them happy, that makes them excited. And when that makes them excited, that makes them want to do what you did. And then when that happens, guess what? You have a client. You have a prospect. You have someone who wants to follow down behind you. You have someone who wants to follow in your footsteps. But you have to have action. You have to have action. Family relationships, the same thing. Family and relationships. Many of us have relationships, man, we're not proud of, we're not happy in. Maybe it's because we rushed into it. Maybe it's because, you know, we thought it was something else, but years later, it turned out to be something totally different. And sometimes you wonder, what went wrong? He wasn't like that, you know, when I first met. Or she wasn't like that, you know, when we first met. So, something wrong. Think about what happened. Backtrack. What was it that you think that caused him or her to feel this way? Maybe you were disrespected in a way. Maybe he or she did something to you that was that they thought it was small, but to you, it was a big deal. You know? And, you know, find out what it is. Family members. You have to be very creative, man. Creating your goals. Everyday life is what you make it, man. Okay? Life sometimes just throws us curveballs. Things just happen. But most of the time, what we do it on our own. We do it, you know, we can only blame ourselves. If you look at the reality to it, we can only blame ourselves. So, you know, whatever it is, man, you want to do in life, sit down, first of all, and find out what it is that you want to do. Once you have established that, then write it down on paper. Each step that you have to go to reach this goal. Now, you may want to buy a car. It's all the same, whatever it is. Okay, well, you know, first of all, you got to have some kind of income. You have to have a job. Okay? Put money each side a week or 2 weeks or a month, how do you get paid, man, towards this car. Okay? Whatever it is you want to do, it's the same process. Because if you don't write it down, you know, you're going to lose interest. You're going to fade away. It's going to fade, you know. You're going to find yourself wandering off doing other things besides the main thing that you want to do. Believe in your mind, okay? You have to see it first. You have to have a vision. Have a vision. Oh, my God. If you have a vision, man, that's when you know you got to go to work. Because it may not come back again. It may not come back a second time. So whatever it is, man, find out what it is. Write it down, and take action, man. Once you take action, once you work towards your goal, you'll see results. And when you see results, that's when you'll start to believe. Okay? Now, I want to leave this with you. It's a quote from Anthony Roberts. Like I said yesterday, I had a chance to see one of his videos. It's a quote, and it says, "Make it so today is not like yesterday, and tomorrow will be different forever." I'm going to read it again. "Make it so today is not like yesterday, and tomorrow will be different forever." So make your choice today. Decide what it is that you want to do today. Yesterday you might have said, you know, I'm going to change my life. I'm going to lose weight. I'm going to make some extra money. I'm going to meet some new friends. And you didn't do it. Okay. But today is a whole new day. It's a whole new day. Start today. Start right now. Changing your life. Okay. It's not like yesterday. But tomorrow will be a different forever. It could make a difference in your life forever. Starting today. Tomorrow will be. You listen to the Bruce Brooks Radio Show. Baltimore's number one station. Get it ready for part two coming up right here on Magic 957 FM.